Our words are lightly spoken, said Pearse to Connolly. Maybe a breath of politic words has withered our rose tree, or maybe but a wind that blows across the bitter sea. It needs to be but watered, James Connolly replied, to make the green come out again and spread on every side, and shake the blossom from the bud to be the garden's pride. But where can we draw water, said Pearse to Connolly, when all the wells are parched away? Oh, plain as plain can be, there's nothing but our own red blood can make a right rose tree. A great crowd had gathered outside of Kilmainham, their heads all uncovered, they knelt on the ground. For inside that grim prison lay a brave Irish soldier, his life for his country about to lay down. He went to his death like a true son of Ireland. The firing party he bravely did face. Then the order rang out, present arms, fire. James Connolly fell into a ready-made grave. A black flag they hoisted, the cruel deed was over. Gone was the man who loved Ireland so well. There was many a sad heart in Dublin that morning, and they murdered James Connolly, the Irish rebel. Many years have rolled by now since the Irish rebellion, and the guns of Britannia they loudly did speak. And the brave IRA marched shoulder to shoulder, and the blood from their bodies flowed down Sackville Street. The four courts of Dublin they cruelly bombarded, the spirit of freedom they tried hard to quell. But above all the din came the cry, no surrender. 'Twas the voice of James Connolly, the Irish rebel.